Hello, my dear students. I am fine, and I hope that all of you will be fine. As students, we discussed in our previous class about chapter 1, formation of numbers and international system of numeration. In this class, I am going to discuss with you a new chapter, chapter 2. The name of the chapter is Roman numbers. As student, the number which you study, we write, is called Hindu-Arabic number. And for Hindu-Arabic number, we write numbers in other form, using some symbols, and that form of number is called Roman numbers. For example, we write I for 1, we write symbol V for 5, we write symbol X for 10, we write symbol L for 50, we write symbol C for 100, symbol D for 500, and symbol M for 1000. With the help of these symbols, we write each and every Hindu-Arabic number in Roman numbers. Look at here. In our day-to-day life, we use these numbers, means Roman numbers also. And for 1, we write Roman number I. For 2, we write 2 times I. For 3, we write 3 times I. For 4, we write the combination of the symbols I. Means to write the Roman numerals, we write the sum symbols. Here I am going to discuss first. This symbol is used for 1, this symbol is used for 5, this symbol X is used for 10, symbol L is used for 50, symbol C is used for 100, symbol D is used for 500, and symbol M is used for 1000. So these are the symbols which we use to write the Roman numbers. Okay, to write the Roman numbers we use these symbols, but we have to follow some rules. There are some rules when we are going to write any Roman number. And the first rule is that we repeat 1 and 10 maximum 3 times. Means the repetition of the symbol for 1 and symbol for 10 is maximum for 3 times. We cannot write 4 times. That's why you are seeing here, I have written for 1. 1i, I have written for 2i, for 3i, but for 4, I have not written 4 times I, because a rule states that we cannot use a symbol more than 3 times. Means the repetition of a symbol more than 3 times does not allow. Okay, similarly, if we have to write 5, then we write this 6. Then we write like this. Now, the second rule is that if we are going to write a symbol, we are going to write a symbol right to the greater symbol. It means we are going to add the symbol. And if we are going to write a symbol whose value is a smaller before a greater symbol value, then we subtract. For example, I have here IV. From here you can compare, the value for V is 5. Value for V is 5. And value for I is 1. So if it is written before V, it means we have to subtract 1. Means 5 minus 1, that's why it is 4. That's why we write IV. Means 5 minus 1, that is 4. I hope you understood. And if we are writing a symbol, a smaller symbol after a bigger symbol, that time we will add. For example, you see, here also two symbols together, then addition is there. Here means 5 plus 1. 1, I is for 1 and B is for 5. So here we write 5 plus 1, that is 6. If before it is, then we subtract, and after it is, then we add. If we have to write 30, in Roman number, we write 10 three times. It means 10 plus 10 plus 10. Clear? You remember we cannot write any of the symbol more than three times, and we have to also learn that which are the symbols are going to be repeated. You remember symbol B, symbol L and symbol D never repeated. These symbols we never repeat. If we have to write 10, so we cannot write 5 and 5. I have here x plus x plus x means triple x I have, and then 10 plus 10 plus 10, 30. So you think that if we have to write 10, then we can write 5, 5, and we add here 5 plus 5, which is equal to 10. No, this is not possible. Because you have to remember the rule that 5, that is symbol B, symbol L or symbol D, never repeated. Clear? So these are the things we have discussed in this chapter. Suppose you have to write 40. So 40, you cannot write 4 times x. This is not true. Means it is not possible to write 4 times x, as it is rule that we cannot repeat any of the Roman symbol more than 3 times. So we write adjective for 40. X L. As you know, L has the value 50 and X has the value 10. And X is written before L, it means we have to subtract. Means 50 minus 10, that is 40. If we have 60, then see here. L X. X is written after L. So we will add here. 50 plus 10, which is 60. Like this, you can write the Roman numbers for any Hindu Arabic number. So these are the three rules given here. You have given one table also. In this table, it is written Roman number up to 39. You can read easily. How to write? You will write these numbers in your notebook also, and then you will do exercise 2.1 in your homework. Means your homework is exercise 2.1. Remember, you must write the rules in your notebook and the numbers up to 39 in your notebook. Thereafter you will do exercise in homework, that is exercise 2.1. I hope you understood. So thank you, students, for today's class. Bye.